These are not Legos, and they are one of the amazing projects that I found when I visited the Rocky Mountain Rap Rap Festival in Loveland, Colorado. These are printer blocks, which are 3D printed interlocking building bricks, so you can finally use your 3D printer for something useful. Let's find out more. Guten Tag, everybody. I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by Voxel PLA. Get 1 kilo of their reliable Pro PLA for only $16.99 with free shipping in the US when ordering 3 spools or more. Visit them at voxelpla.com. Just talking about something that is like Legos but not Legos comes with the risk that this video is getting copyright striked any second. Yet today I still want to talk about a great 3D printed alternative to the well-known Danish plastic bricks. These are 3D printable interlocking blocks designed by the 3D printing professor, and if you have a 3D printer, making some of these might finally be a great use for it. So I've known Joe for quite a while because he's also a fellow 3D printing YouTuber, and I finally had the chance to talk with him about one of his amazing projects called PrinterBlock. So I've already said it a bunch of times, PrinterBlock is a system of interlocking parts specifically designed to be 3D printed. If you ever tried to print a regular Lego brick, you might have noticed that they have quite tight tolerances, so depending on your machine, they might not be connectable at all or directly fall apart. They might make a good tolerance test, but they're not meant to be 3D printed. PrinterBlock, on the other hand, is. The base block is just this cube that has these diamond-shaped holes on every surface. They're designed in such a way that they can be printed in any orientation. Then you have connector pieces. You just pop them into a hole, which then finally allows you to connect it to any other piece. And honestly, they are really satisfying to use. But printer blocks aren't just boring rectangular bricks that you connect to each other. Joe designed over the years a couple of different themed sets around the printer block system. There are mechs, beasts, spaceships, and he recently launched castle terrains for your next Dungeons & Dragons session. Joe designed all of his creations in Blender, and I was really amazed by the amount of details you can find on the parts. And since he knows what you can and can't 3D print, all of the parts happily print without any supports on your home 3D printer. The simple blocks with basic articulation can be downloaded for free, and I put a link in the description. Joe doesn't sell printed printer blocks, but if you want to get more sophisticated designs, you can purchase these files from his store. There might be some who complain right here, but hey, he has put a ton of creative work into his designs, and the price for the files are quite fair. And just to be clear right here, even though he sells some printer block sets, Joe didn't patent or protect the connection mechanism in any way. Actually, quite the opposite. He freely shares the files and encourages people to use and contribute to the printer block system.
So, printer block is not just this. It's a system that other people can contribute to and be a part of. And I'm afraid I said that in my salesman-y voice, but it sounds good on video.
Since printed printer blocks are toys, you will have to be careful with small kids because these are a choking hazard. And Joe even told me that he had to learn quite a bit about toy safety when he first released them. Yet printer blocks are scalable, so you can print them at 150% or even 200% scale, for example, to make them a bit safer and probably also a bit less finicky to use. If I just think about how many Legos I had when I was young, I could see myself playing even with these just standard bricks for hours. And honestly, printer blocks are not just a plain 3D printable copy of Legos, because since you can connect pieces onto every side, this is not only a 3D printing experience, but also a true 3D building experience. The blocks are very small and might be a great way to finally use up all of the filament samples and 90% empty spools that you all have lying around. Joe also told me about a really interesting idea regarding using leftovers. So, most multicolor printers have the problem that they need to purge a ton of material when transitioning from one color to another. Yet Bamboo Slicer has a neat feature that lets you purge into an object instead of just pooping out the material and/or using a purge tower. Joe told me that this is still a bit buggy, but hey, if it works at some point, I'd be happy to trade in the purging poop with a printer block. I had a great time chatting with the 3D printing professor, and I always enjoy being at events like this. If you want to try out printer blocks, then just download the base set, and if you're getting hooked, you can also get more from Joe's online store. And if you want to print with more than just your leftover filament samples, then check out today's video sponsor Voxel PLA, who sells one of the most affordable yet reliable materials in the US. Voxel PLA Pro sells for only $16.99 per 1 kilo spool. They ship free in the US if you order 3 spools or more, and if you need larger quantities, they even offer bulk discounts. Voxel PLA recently introduced 3 new colors: lavender purple, ice clear, and forest green. Many of the filaments are in stock and ready to ship out the same day. Voxel PLA developed their PLA Pro for their own print farm, where they run over 150 production machines, so you can be sure that you'll get a reliable material for your own projects or your business. So if you live in the US and want to restock your filament, visit them at voxelpla.com. Thanks to Voxel PLA for sponsoring this video.